ربنا يا ربنا، ربنا يا ربنا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. صدق الله العظيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed down Surah Al-Ikhlas, sincerity, purity, to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mecca. And the occasion and the reason behind the revelation of this surah, a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling him, describe to me your Lord. Is your Lord made of silver or gold, or is he made of wood? And has he got any family? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam waited for the wahi, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, قل, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and reply to them, قل هو الله أحد. He is the one and only. الله الصمد. Allah, لفظ الجلالة. الله الصمد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that people will be turning to. He is the one that people are in need of. And he is self-sufficient. الله الصمد. لم يلد. He does not have no children. ولم يولد. Nor he is begotten. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدٍ. And there is nothing comparable to him, سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. There are nothing, that there is no one that is similar to him, سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. He is beyond our imagination. And subhanAllah, the best way to know عَظَمَةُ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, to see the universe and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it. If that's the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how about the creator? Let us learn the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his names and his attributes, to know how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this surah is so great because it talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever recites Surah Al-Ikhlas, then he shall be getting a reward as if he recited third of the Quran. It's as if you've recited third of the Quran. Why? Because the scholars, they mentioned the entire Quran is centered, or the themes of it is one of the three. So one third of it is stories about prophets, one third of it is legislations, rules, and one third of it is about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and about his names and attributes. So if you recite Surah Al-Ikhlas, is as if you covered that third. And of course, in reward, inshallah, hopefully, is like someone who recited the third of the Quran, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that in the hadith. And another hadith about this blessed surah, a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, I frequently recite Surah Al-Ikhlas. I quite love that surah. So he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because of your love to Surah Al-Ikhlas, that will be the reason for your entrance into Jannah, subhanallah. So it's a blessed surah, and we know it's a short surah, and we often recite it in our salawat. This is from the sunnah, because the Prophet ﷺ used to recite it in his voluntary prayers. And we recite another surah in the Quran as well, which is short, and it's Surah Al-Kawthar. And look at the correlation between both surah. So if we recite them on every day, that's our religion, because Surah Al-Ikhlas is about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Surah Al-Kawthar is about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defended him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakum Allah khair for listening, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Rabbana ya Rabbana.